خلاص بدو.
The pectoral muscles in tone line. How to stretch the pectoral muscles in tone line. So put the feet in tone line. Okay. Put the feet in tone line. Okay. Make sure that the hand should be abducted to 90 degrees to stretch the horizontal fibers. If you want to stretch the oblique fibers, the hand should be 120 degrees. Understood what I'm talking? So the therapist should be behind. Okay. Okay. So stabilize the pelvis. Okay. And say example, you want to stretch the pectoral muscles in 90 degrees position. Okay. Hold the hands like this. Okay. And ask the kid to come up actively. Okay. So we are stretching the pectoral muscles and the kid and we are strengthening the back extensors also. Understood what I'm talking?
Yes.
Okay. So the kid should be in prone line. The hand should be abducted to 90 degrees. The therapist should be behind. Hold the arms in 90 degrees abduction. Ask the kid to come up slowly with head and neck extension, spine extension. So automatically, okay, the pectoral muscles will get stretched. Okay. The pelvis should be stabilized. Okay. The patient should be, the chest should be out of the ball. Understood? The same exercise can be done on bolster also. Okay. The same exercise you can do on the bolster also. Okay. Prone line. Okay. The same exercise the kid can do on bolster also. Okay. So this is active stretching of pectoral muscles. Okay, so these are some of the important muscles, especially latissimus dorsi and pectoralis muscles, which go for common tightness. Because of this, what happens? The kid can't use the upper limbs properly. So these muscles we have to emphasize in stretching, especially in spastic diaplegics. It can be spastic quadriplegics. Okay, so that is about stretching for the upper limbs. Now coming to how to facilitate the abdominals. How to facilitate the abdominal muscles. Because most of the kids, you can take any type of cerebral palsy. It can be spastic, quadriplegic, diaplegic, ataxic, or it can be achitard varieties. Most of these kids doesn't use abdominals properly. So abdominals are poor, weak. So we have to facilitate these abdominals. For any kind of functional activity, it can be sitting, it can be doing standing or walking activities, abdominal muscles are very, very important. So in all these kids, in all types of cerebral palsy kids, the abdominal muscles will be weak or very poor. So it is very important to facilitate. So how we can facilitate these abdominal muscles? So, okay, so make sure that the kid should be in, okay, sideline position, okay. So, say example, the kid should be in sideline position, okay. So, this is the position, okay. Hold one hand on the lower hand on your hand and one hand hold the thigh. Okay, slowly take the kid down. Ask the kid to come up. You understand what I'm talking? Okay. The kid should be in sideline position. Okay. You have to hold the lower hand on your hand. Okay. And you have to hold the thigh of the lower leg. Okay. Slowly take the kid down. Now ask the kid to come up. To come up like this. To come up like this. So not from, forwards, towards me. Okay. I am taking the kid, I am taking like this. Understood what I am talking? Now the kid should come up. When the kid wants to come up, the kid should use the abdominal muscles to come up. Understand what I am talking? Okay. So the kid should be in sideline position. okay, you have to hold the lower aspect of the arm in your hand, and you have to hold the lower thigh in your hand, and slowly take the kid down. Now ask the kid to come up towards you. When the kid wants to come towards you, the kid has to use the abdominal muscles to come up, because the ball is a dynamic surface. Is it clear what I'm trying to say? Okay, so this is one kind of, this is one of the important exercises to facilitate the abdominal muscles. So as I said, abdominal muscles are very important for any kind of functional activity. It can be sitting, it can be walking, it can be from supine to coming to sideline or sitting. For any kind of activity, abdominal muscles we should use. As I said, most of the cerebral palsy kids, abdominal muscles will be very, very poor or weak. Okay, this is the way we can facilitate the abdominal muscles on the ball. Abdominals, obliques, all those things will get strengthened or facilitated by this position. Okay. Now, coming to how to strengthen the back extensors. Okay, when you want to strengthen back extensors, okay, the kid should be lying in prone line. Okay, make sure that the upper limb should be in 140 degrees of flexion. Okay, ask the kid to hold the any stick on the hand. Okay, and once the kid is able to hold the stick on the hand, now ask the kid to come up slowly. Understand what I'm talking? The upper limb should be in 140 degrees of flexion, complete flexion, like this, in prone line. Okay, the kid should be holding the stick. Okay, now ask the kid to come up slowly. Okay, so in this position we are strengthening the head and neck extensors, back extensors, and we are stretching the pectoral muscles also by this activity. Is it clear what I'm trying to say? Understood? So this is one of the important activity which strengthens the back extensors. This is for back extensors. Whenever the kid goes to prone line, when he comes up, please do understand, okay, the trunk extensor muscles are the ones which are getting strengthened, the head and neck extensors are the one which is getting strengthened, and the upper limbs are getting stretched, especially the pectoral muscles, the serratus anterior muscles are the muscles which go for stretching. Is it clear what I'm trying to say? Okay, so these are some of the exercises for back extensors, abdominal muscles, and how to stretch the pectoral muscles using ball and ball strength. Okay, any queries, any questions? Any queries, any questions? We'll see. Any queries, any questions? Okay, so these are some of the important exercises for upper limbs and lower limbs. I'll be telling you how to facilitate sit to stand and standing. Okay, so if you want, you can practice. Then I'll teach some more exercises, 3-4 exercises after 5-10 minutes. Okay, any questions?